What's up, Nail Geeks, and welcome back to another Fandom Flakies video on this rainy day. It's storming. I know you guys can't see the window in front of me here, but it's got a wonderful thunderstorm going on, so I apologize if this is a touch dark than normal while I still try to figure out all the lighting situation and whatnot. This month we have the theme Doctor Strange, and our guest maker is Kathleen and Co. Per usual, we're going to go in alphabetical order, so let's dive right into the swatches.
So first up, we've got Bee's Knees Lacquer. I do it and I become the enemy. This is described as a rich red polish with red to green multi-chrome flakes, hollow flakes, and a scattering of matte black flakes. This has a wonderful, juicy, jelly-type formula. It's got a light squishy factor to it, so I don't think there's any need to be careful with your brush strokes or anything like that. It builds up like liquefied jello on the nail, and I'm going to suggest going up to 3 light coats on it. This is wonderful in how it builds up, and when you go up to that third coat, it just maximizes that flaky payoff. This is so pretty and flattering. It has a warm tone with all of the flakes, but the base color itself has that nice cooling tone to it. So I think if you have warm undertones like myself, then it's going to pop very well on you. This does dry down semi-flat, so I think any glossy top coat is perfect. Now next up, we've got Night Owl Lacquer, It's Not About You. This is described as a black base glowing with gold, bronze, copper, green, microflake shimmer, and holographic micro flakes. This polish is stunning. Lindsay outdid herself with this one. I swatched it and I was just floored when I put it on. Now, I want to note that on my application here, I took it up to 3 coats. That third coat was more of a formality in that it just kind of evened everything out. I think if you have natural nails and you don't have a layer of, you know, gel overlay or dip, whatever, I think 2 normal coats are going to be just fine. This is something else. It's so pretty and shifty and wonderful. You can see on my full hand shot here that glorious copper to green shift, very obvious, and those holographic flakes just, this one really just stole the show. I think going in with a glossy top coat will maximize all of those beautiful hollow sparkles. And finally, we've got Kathleen & Co. This is Gap Junction, described as a purple base with hollow flecks, pink and orange iridescent flakes, aqua to blue iridescent micro flakes, and black matte flakes. This is a very flattering purple. It's got that nice cool undertone when you build it up to opacity. It does have a strong squish factor. I think you can get a good idea of that on that second coat here. So make sure you're going in lighter on your coats and not overworking it to prevent any sort of balding, what have you, and just go in light. I'm kind of floating the polish on this third coat here, and I think that's giving you a better idea of what I would recommend in terms of how to apply this. This does dry down flat and a touch thirsty, so I'm going to suggest a good glossy top coat with a touch of thickness to it, or you can combo it with a glitter smoother of some type. And Ribbits and Stickets has our add-ons this month. You can grab the Oh for Fox's Sake vinyl for $4, or you can also get the Waterslide decal sheet here for $8. These are super cute, very fun. I wasn't sure what I was going to do for my nail art this month, so I just did something pretty simple. It also occurred to me that I've never showed you guys me actually cutting them out. This is prefaced with me staring at the Waterslide decal sheets for a minimum of maybe 10 minutes trying to figure out what I'm going to do, and then I commit to actually cutting. So the first one I'm doing here on my middle nail, I'm just doing a very tiny cutout makeup sponge. These are cheapies. I'm very frugal when it comes to my supply stuff. If I can get something for really cheap, I'm going to do it. This sponge bag I bought from a dollar store several years ago. I'm just now down to the last 3 in the bag. They have done me very good. So sponge on some white. That's one way you can do the Waterslide decals. Easy peasy. This is kind of a more of a airbrushed sort of way, I guess, for lack of better words, kind of like a spray paint sort of look. We look really cute with a gradient or what have you. I like to make sure that the decal is pretty dry on my stamper. Of course, you don't have to use a stamper. Those of you who are familiar with this series, y'all know the drill. This is what I do every single month. I just felt like the bee's knees in this box really spoke to me, especially with the magical circle appearance, like what that looks like, and his cape, all of that good stuff. I just thought it popped really well with the vinyls themselves. And then I'm also showing you guys what I do when I'm going in with my top coat. As long as you squeezed out the water and you were pretty careful with how you were applying, these are pretty forgiving and they lay down nice and flat. So when you cut them out, just make sure that I like to cut them as close to the image as possible so I get as minimal overlap as possible for cleanup.
All right, so the last extra I have to show you guys is Ribbits and Stickets Hand and Cuticle Cream. I will spare you guys all of my raving about it. I have done lots and lots of Fandom Flakies videos over the last couple of years, I dare say. So y'all know how I feel about it. It's a fantastic formula, wonderful hand cream. But this month's scent is in the scent Endless Loop and is described as having top notes of almond and bergamot, middle notes of coconut, shea, amber, honey, coriander, and the base notes is cedar, sandalwood, light musk, tonka bean, wood, tobacco, and I'm going to say this wrong, so feel free to correct me in the comment section. Weed, O-U-D. I don't know if I'm saying that right. So we've got a very earthy sort of smell. I really feel like this one has just a touch of a unisex sort of scent to it, but it does have a kind of almost sweet lean, if that makes sense. So I'm definitely getting that nice woodsy tone in the forefront, and then I'm getting that sandalwood and a touch of that cedary sort of scent at the end. So this month is more I would say earthy, woodsy sort of, with just a touch of sweetness, and that's probably from the tonka bean at the end notes there. So the box is going to go up for pre-order starting this Friday, February 10th at noon Eastern time, and will run until February 17th at 11:59 p.m. Eastern time. The box is $33 plus shipping, and of course you can always add on the extras from Ribbits and Stickets and however much. Not only is there the hand and cuticle cream, but we've also got acetone additive. And don't forget, Fandom Flakies box now has the option to subscribe. So you can have it just recurring every single month. I would recommend that, because this is one of those boxes, in my opinion, that's really worth it. They're always so fabulous and wonderful, and you can also customize that option too. So I will have all this in the description box. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching.